Hello everybody, 98 Reviews. Today we're here with a 1984 Oldsmobile 98 Regency Brougham. Original Survivor, 42,000 kilometers, winter car, so we do have a little bit of rust, but we just want to show it to you guys. We're going to get a little review going here and let you know our thoughts from Canada on the Olds 98 Regency Brougham. Taking a look at the front, I just want to note that this is a huge car, wide, long. I mean, we're way out of the parking spot here. It's fabulous. Looking at the front, we have the dual halogen lights. Now, for those of you that don't know the history behind these, I believe General Motors brought these out on the 98 around in the mid-70s and the other GM models. I'm a big fan of these over the circular GM headlights. I love these things. Halogen, they're lovely. Looking at the front here, I mean, you know, you do have some watermarks, some paint, etc., but it is an Oldsmobile, and it's just meant to be driven, and that's why we like it. Big car. Come around this side for a second just to show you guys the length of this vehicle. Really long, I believe it's a 223-inch overall length of the vehicle. And you're probably thinking right now, we don't have white walls. No, we don't. For the comment section, we do not have white walls. That is because there was a backlog. I wanted to get this thing on the road, so I picked the Firestone, the highway tires. They're the destination. They're nice, smooth. I just glide down the road on this thing. I mean, me and my cameraman over here, we didn't even tap the gas on the way to this parking lot, so fabulous.
No, we didn't.
Fabulous. So just a little close-up on the wheel over here. I believe these are 15s, and this is the original rim here, chrome. Everything's nice. Oldsmobile emblems all over the car. Lovely. I did not put tire cleaner on for this video, because we drive it a lot, so... Around here, you know, the 98 emblem, we're missing a little bit of that cursive action, but you can make it out. Like I said, this is a Canadian driver, and I'm 18 years old. I do not need a mint. Coming around the back here, a lot of questions I get asked is, why are the mirrors so small? I don't know, you tell me, people from the 80s, why are the mirrors so small? That's an answer we're all looking for. I cannot see anything when I back this thing up. And I know I'm not a tall guy, but no, I can't see anything. Coming down the side here, Regency Brougham emblem. This is not a base model, for those of you wondering. I really like the rear fenders here. Really nice touch, because I do remember the 70s Oldsmobiles. They didn't have these, or some of them had them. I believe the 77 or 78, 79, they didn't have these. This is a nice touch. This makes it look exactly like what it should be. Luxury, and I love it. Coming around the back here, as you can see, you know, we do have a little bit of rust around here, but we're not gonna focus on that stuff. Take a look at the back. So you can see the overall length, long as you can see. It took us about 20 minutes just to get to the back here or whatever it did. This is the trunk here. Huge Oldsmobile. We're going to get into this in a second. Nice trunk. I like this. Reverse lights. These pillar lights. Really nice. Again, Oldsmobile. Chrome bumper. Solid. I feel totally safe in this thing. It's insane. And yeah, let's pop the hood for you guys real quick. Now, mind you, I didn't clean it out for this video because this is a nice driver, show car, but it's big. I want to show usable space in this vehicle because here we go. Spare tire, factory spare, oil, whatever, our jugs, our cover, our Noco battery charger. Highly recommend this to maintain your car if you're surviving these Canadian winters. And, you know, jack instructions, everything's here. Everything's original. Everything's nice. Give it a nice slam to close. Here's another little tip for you guys. This license plate right here, we have our gas cap down there. It's a very nice touch, nice and hidden so we don't ruin the body lines. Let's come around the driver's side of the car. Same thing as the passenger side, except there's a steering wheel. Let's get into that really quickly. But before I do, I just want to mention, this is the vinyl top. This is the vinyl top. This car was in its past parked outside, which is why we do have some surface tears over here. But the most important part about this car is that the Regency Brome is looking kind of mint. Let's take a look at the driver thing. Get rid of this towel here. We had a little bit of rain, so. This is the interior, driver's side. The interior is one of my favorite parts about this car because we do have that red velour 80s classic feel with that black. Let our cameraman show you the inside here. Lots of room, people. Lots and lots of room. I believe we have 42,000 on the dash as well. So that's the interior. I wanted to note one thing. As you can see, underneath the steering wheel, these two gauges right here. These are not factory. So I added those. I believe that's from a Chevelle or some Chevy, and I added those for oil pressure and temperature because, you know, these cars, they really told you absolutely nothing, and it's insane. Let's check out the back. The back seat is my favorite part because you can pile in everybody you want in this thing. I mean, six total seats, really comfortable. You know what, I'm actually gonna sit in the back to show you guys the room we have here. So this is with the seat almost all the way back for the driver. And this is how we go. I am 5'7½", maybe 5'8" on a good day. And I'm also wearing a hat. So I'm probably 5'9" total height.
And like you could round it to 5'10", honestly.
Yeah, I can round it to 5'10". You know what? Forget about it. With these shoes, I'm 6 foot and I'm just sitting here. Wow. I mean, this is insane. On the highway, I could hold on to this when we're like really picking up speed in this 140 horsepower 307. Wow. Another thing I want to mention here, we have an armrest here. So this is, if you don't have that third person, you know, the armrest, it comes down, stitching's a little bit okay, but comes down and wow, this is amazing. And I just want to note one more thing. For those of you that are really big smokers, we do have ashtrays all over the car here. So there's the ashtray, cigarette lighter that still works. Fantastic. This is just a fantastic car. There's the ashtray. I mean, power windows. I can show you these power windows. Shit, we don't have the we don't have the ignition on right now, so we'll get to that later. Yeah, so that's it. If you want to make note, there's another Oldsmobile emblem on the top of the velour seats, top right of each seat. There's an Olds emblem, so that's nice. And we also have little lamps on each top. Yeah, right there, little reading lamps. Very elegant. Get out of the back. I think let's talk about the powertrain of this car, and maybe we should pop the hood. That would be appropriate for a vehicle of this age. Let's go around the front here, check out the hood and the engine. I did not clean the engine bay, nor did I make it look pretty. This is as it is. This is as stock as it gets. Absolutely no modifications. 307. Yeah, speaking about the 307, so this is a 5-liter 307 General Motors V8, first generation for those of you wondering. There were two generations, one from 80 to 84 and then 85 to 90. 85 to 90 was a little bit of a slug. Even this one, I know I'm gonna have people saying, oh no, no, the 307's a slug. No, it isn't. I keep up in traffic, no problem, with 140 horsepower and around 220 pound-feet of torque. It's nice. It's a V8, obviously, for those of you still questioning that. And overall, it's really nice. It has the Rochester Quadrajet carburetor. That's what they came from factory, if you're wondering. It's underneath this fuel filter here. We cannot show you today, but I did do a rebuild on that, so it fires up instantaneously. So we're gonna close the hood, and maybe what we'll do is we'll fire this puppy up for you guys. Let me know when.
All right, rolling. How long have you had this car?
This car has been in the family forever. This was originally my grandfather's car. Unfortunately, he passed, and then it was gonna go to the junkyard actually because my family didn't want to deal with the headache. But we discussed it and we figured it's totally worth keeping and keeping grandpa's spirit alive and just cruising and having an 84 old. So we decided, you know what? It's been sitting for a while. It does need some work. It was outside a little bit too. So that vinyl top, left signal, sorry. So everything works, by the way. But anyways, the vinyl top, you know, those tears, but those things cosmetically, I'm gonna get to, but mechanically this thing's totally safe. It's strong. 307 runs nice. We did a carburetor, we did the front end, shocks, alignment, all of this. And now we're good to go. It's road ready, new tires, the brakes, everything runs, works nice. So that's the story of this car. But I've been with this car as long as I can remember, and I love this thing. I mean, Oldsmobiles are unmatched. So steering goes straight. I don't even have to touch this thing, although I will keep 10 and 2, but look at that. Steering alignment, totally lovely. You know, we're not gonna hot rod it because it is a small block and it is old. We're just doing the speed limit, we're just cruising. I like this road, there's no speed bumps or anything like that. It's just a really nice cruise. You know, you don't really require much footwork on this Oldsmobile. I mean, the 4-speed overdrive automatic, I have it in regular drive right now. No problems at all. 3-speed, really smooth, shifts lovely. I mean, absolutely fabulous. This is just amazing. So like I said, 42,000 kilometers. The one thing I did want to point out, this steering wheel actually, this isn't for an, I'm actually not too sure, but from my understanding, this is from an 85-98. And for those of you familiar with the 85s, they downsized those to the front wheel drive V6s. But I like this one, it's skinny, it's nice. The alignment's perfect, straightaway here. Let's get up to speed. Now if I let go of the gas, silence, you can hear the wind, it sounds like an electric motor. This is just fabulous. So luxurious. It literally floats like a Cadillac. Although it isn't, it floats like one. Just cut the video. Back at the lot here, swinging into a spot and set you guys off back to YouTube. I like to reverse park this thing just because I like to look at the front end of things.
Hit it one more time for the gentleman. Yeah, it's recording.
There you have it, folks. Oldsmobile 98. Done, and done. Thank you. Enjoy this 223-inch overall length here. This is insane. My arm span is not even as long as this car. Enjoy this. Let our cameraman do the work of just giving you one last shot of the Oldsmobile, and we're done. Thank you for watching.
All right, guys, that was the cameraman. I hope you liked the video. This was the 1984 Olds. They don't make them like they used to. The 98 Regency Brome. This is 98 Reviews. Hope you like this video, and if you want more videos, drop a like, leave a couple comments, and yeah, see you in the next video. Nothing left for me to do about this.